Today we're gonna take a look at new eyewear. If you have followed my channel for a while, you might have seen me do several videos reviewing eyewear before. It has been a long while since then, but I did both a Fab Optic and an Extra Optical review in 2016. And then 2 years ago, I did another Extra Optical review, but I never ended up with any of the glasses that I reviewed in that video. So I'm really excited for today's video because I have my first collaboration with a brand. So probably because of my earlier reviews, TIJN Eyewear reached out to me through email and really just asked me if I wanted to try a few of their frames and make a video about it. And the only requirements were that I put TIJN in the title and that I would put links in my description box, which I felt was almost too good to be true. But just to put the disclaimer out there that they did not tell me what to say about their glasses or their websites, I'm not being paid to review them, but they did sponsor the frames that I'm gonna show you in the video. So I did get the eyewear for free, but it's up to me to review them from my own perspective. So I had never heard about this brand, which seemed to be Dutch, but I'm also in Norway, so I wouldn't know much about international eyewear brands. I usually try to shop locally or at least within my own country, mostly because the shipping fees can be quite high. But I also noticed that TIJN Eyewear has free shipping on all of their orders, I think, which is really great. And overall, the prices on their glasses seem pretty affordable too, at least compared to the other reviews I've done. It seemed to be kind of the same price range. But then again, you also have the option with free shipping, which makes it kind of better, at least for potential international customers like me. So I was free to choose two different frames of glasses. And they also told me that one of these could have the blue light filter on them. So just a quick explanation if you don't know what blue light filter is that the glass has a slight yellow tint to it, so that it filters out blue light that usually comes from computers or phones, which has been known to trick your brain into thinking that it's sunlight and it can keep you awake at night. And I've always been interested in that feature, so I did choose one eyewear with that option. They also told me about this new feature that I don't think I've ever seen before, which was anti-fog lenses. I think on their website there was a small video of someone drinking a cup of coffee or tea and the lenses would not get fog on them, which to me also seemed pretty cool, but personally I'm not in those situations very often. I'm nearsighted, so I usually wear my glasses for either driving or maybe when I'm working, but when I'm just at home or indoors I usually don't wear my glasses, so for me it's not really that big of a problem. But I can see how it would be maybe really convenient for other people who wear their glasses every day. But at the time when they reached out to me, they only had three different frames available with the anti-fog option, and none of them were really to my liking, so I decided to skip that one for now, until later on when they might have more options regarding the frames. But let's take a look at the two glasses that I decided to get. So they were shipped to me just in a bubble wrap envelope like this. Even though it is a Dutch company, the glasses seem to be shipped from China because it is from China Post. So I don't know if they manufacture their glasses there or if they just have their warehouse there. But I took a glance at their website and on there it was written that they provide safe and healthy environment for their lab workers. So if that is true, then I don't really mind where they come from. Because they were shipped from China all the way to me in Norway, I expected it to take, I don't know, maybe up to a month, especially now with COVID and everything. Even national mail has been kind of slow recently. But from they reached out to me and to when I got them, it was 16 days, so just a little over 2 weeks, which I don't think was bad at all. And inside the bubble wrap envelope, they had a separate cardboard box. They also state that they use minimalist and eco-friendly packaging for the good of our planet. They have their social tags on there. Both the glasses came with their own separate case, which is really nice. Then the order slip, another social tag card, where you can also get a discount. A small bag with the tool to fix the... I think it's to fix the nose parts on the glasses. I don't know what they are called. And then one of those cloth to wipe the glasses with. I was really impressed with the pouches that they came in. They even have different colors on them, so it's easy to remember what glasses I have in which case if I like leave them on my table or something. And they feel really nice. I don't know if this is real leather, but it kind of smells like it. But yeah, already impressed with the state of these cases. They are really nice and cute. They even have the brand engraved in the fabric, and it's sewn at the edges and have this cute little flap that you just hook onto the metal part. The first pair I wanted to get, I kind of had in mind already before I looked at their website. My old glasses are very bold black and square, and I've kind of always wanted a round pair, and also in like a really nice shiny silver, because I feel it's a staple and it goes with everything. And I did find a pair on their website that I really liked, that was kind of just perfect for my liking, and they are called Henk. And these are kind of just everything I wanted. They have a very shiny silvery metal, very clean and thin frames, super minimalist and not bulky at all. It has the kind of old school nose plates that I like, and very simple handles, if that's what they're called. They don't have any plastic covering the handles behind the ear, but they don't feel uncomfortable at all because they're also very lightweight. Even the nose parts are done in gold color with the T engraved on there, which I think looks really nice. And the gold doesn't really interfere with the glasses at all. So I'll just try these on for you so you can see what they look like on. I think they're very subtle and minimalist. So all in all, very happy with these. I think they would go with any outfit, and they're just very simple and clean looking. So I would definitely wear these as a staple for everyday use. Now, these don't have my prescription in them, so the glass that's in them right now is just clear glass. When they reached out to me and asked me to review two pair of glasses for free, I'm not the type of person to further ask them to give me stuff. So I didn't really want to ask about them being prescription or not, because them offering me glasses in the first place I feel is kind of enough. So because they didn't say anything about the prescription, I decided not to mention it either, because I also feel that the whole purpose of them reaching out to me is to like spread the word about their glasses, and I would be able to do that and review the frames whether they have my prescription or not. So it wasn't really necessary for me to be able to review them. So I definitely can understand that maybe that would be too much of an expense for them. And so that's also why I didn't mention it in the beginning. But these are definitely a type of frame that I would wear often, and that I could see myself changing the glass in them and getting my prescription maybe at a later time. Then moving on to the second pair. Since I already have black square frames from before, and now these silver round frames, I decided to go a bit out of my comfort zone and maybe try something a little bit more fun and different. And honestly, there were so many amazing frames on their website. I don't think they had nearly as many glasses as the Extra Optical website, but still I was even more impressed with this website because the glasses that they did have had really unique and different styles to them. I think you'd be surprised because they have a lot of different variations in not only color and material, but also shapes. Maybe I'll even include a few photos on the side here of some of the frames that I almost decided to get. but that didn't make the cut in the end. I really liked the cat eye shaped glasses, which is what I ended up with, but they did have this other pair that I was looking at first. They had them in two different colors. One was pink, so that was definitely not my thing. But they also had white or transparent, I think. And I just think they look really nice and classy. But alas, not really my style. So I ended up with a black cat eye frame, or black and metal. So let's take a look at them. These also have kind of a rounded shape, at least at the bottom. Maybe a bit more droopy than the silver ones. And then with the cute pointy cat eye on the sides, the black goes on the upper half around the glass, and then it has black plastic on the handles, also with the T logo at the end. And this one has clear nose parts, but also with the logo on it. So let's put those on to compare and do a close-up. These also came in two different color variations, I think. I believe they had regular gold with white, and then these that are rose gold with the black. I don't really do gold or rose gold for that matter, so I kind of wish they had silver with the black. But I just really wanted to try the black cat eye look, and I really like these two. I don't think the rose gold is that prominent that it really makes any difference. They have a very subtle color to them, but I really like the black cat eye look on top. It makes them look more feminine and maybe also more classy. I feel like I should put my hair up and go to work as a teacher or a librarian. The last thing I wanted to talk about was the blue light filter. And since I was kind of out of my comfort zone with the cat eye, I decided that the Henk glasses would be the glasses that I got the blue light filter in. But when I got these, the lenses didn't look yellow at all. And also from watching pictures online, it looked like the glasses were supposed to have either a purple or green tint to them when you looked at them in the light. But mine did not have that. And so I got a little worried that the blue light filter wasn't actually a thing, but hopefully just that they maybe had forgotten to add it. Even though on the order slip I got with these, the blue light filter was marked on there, I decided to contact them on email, telling them like, hey, how do I check that my glasses actually have a blue light filter on them? And they were quick to respond to me with both pictures and even videos that kind of showed the yellow tint and the green or purple shine to them. And I was like, okay, mine actually does not have that, and I'm happy to provide pictures. So I did that, and we emailed like back and forth. They were quick to respond and everything, so I had no issues with that. They had really good customer service. In the end, they figured out that they had done my order wrong and shipped me glasses without the blue light filter. So they actually shipped me a new pair right away, which I thought was fantastic. So then I had to wait for them to reship me the third pair, which I got in another box. This one also came with all the order slips, the social tags, another cloth to wipe the glasses with. It just didn't have the tool, but I'm totally fine with that. But I was really surprised to see the case that they came with, because it was even nicer than the first. So this one actually had a hard case, which I'm really stoked about, because obviously since I don't wear my glasses constantly every day, sometimes I bring them with me and throw them in my bag, and I like to have hard cases so that they don't break or anything when they're being tossed around in my handbag. So it's really nice to have a hard case for that purpose. And it even has a magnetic lid on there, and also like a really cool triangular shape. This one also looks and feels like leather, and to be honest, it kind of also smells like real leather. I'm just really bad at telling the difference, I guess. Inside were just the same pair of Henk glasses, but with the blue filter this time. So I'll put those on, and maybe you can see the shine that they have. I think you already can see that the lenses are slightly darker on my face. And also when I look at the window, maybe you can see that it's kind of green. I'll of course insert a clip here so you can compare the two glasses next to each other and see it better. And obviously this is not a extreme yellow tint, so they wouldn't block out all blue light. I think there's two or three variations of yellow tinted lenses that block out different amounts of blue light. So these would block out just a small percentage of blue light. I have seen a few videos on the topic of blue light filter lenses and if they work or not. From what I've seen, it's kind of confirmed that they do help with not keeping you awake, but you would get a much greater effect the stronger the tint is. So since these have a very small tint, they're not as effective as maybe I would have liked them to be. I've tried to use them on my computer when it's late at night to see if I get tired more easily. But to be honest, I have really not noticed any difference. But there could be a lot of other factors contributing to that. And also, I have not tried them that many times because I also wear a big headset when I'm gaming. And it's not really comfortable having the handles of the glasses under the headset. So I tend to not want to wear glasses when I'm in front of my computer just because I'm also wearing the headset. But I think that if you are interested in blue light filter, that you should try for yourself and see if it actually helps you. And maybe it would also be a good idea to start with a light tint like this before moving on to a stronger tint. I think that was everything I wanted to say about these glasses. I was really surprised about the quality, at least compared to Extra Optical that I reviewed before. I think I'm more impressed with TIJN, just because of the material that is used in these glasses and the different designs and color variations that they have. I think it's amazing. I know that it's hard to tell in a video like this, but when I look at these glasses and I hold them, it does feel like really high quality glasses. I definitely feel like you get more value than you're paying for. So all in all, I'm really impressed by this brand. Because they also have that free shipping option, I think I definitely would have ordered my next pair from this brand, even though I live in a different country. After I received my glasses, I also found out that my YouTube friend that I mentioned in some other videos, they also have two pair of glasses from this brand, and they were also really happy with their glasses. So now it's not just me being sponsored saying this. Like, now there's at least one other person that also likes this brand. If you wear glasses, then I would definitely recommend that you check out their website because they have so many cool and unique frames. And I feel like they're really affordable, at least compared to Norwegian standards. One last thing to mention is that when I was emailing with them back and forth with the blue light filter, I did end up asking them about prescription glasses because that was after I received the first two glasses and I was already really impressed with the frames, and so I kind of really wanted a pair with my prescription in them so that they were actually functional. And so I kind of asked them, like, so if I were to actually buy a pair from you, would you offer me some sort of discount maybe? I at least thought that was kind of plausible since I was reviewing them. And like, I didn't really expect much, maybe even a 10% discount code would be nice. They ended up saying to me that, yeah, we usually offer discounts, but we could also offer you one pair with your prescription for free. So I am actually now waiting for my third pair, technically my fourth pair of TIJN glasses that also has my prescription in them. But they have just been shipped now, I think, so it will be another 2 weeks probably before they arrive. So I wanted to get this video out before that time. So you will see me soon again with another TIJN review. I'll leave the link to their website and also to the glasses I got in the description box so you can check them out if you want to. Let me know in the comments which was your favorite pair. As always, a huge thank you to my patrons who make these videos happen. And then I hope to see you in my next video. Vi ses.